Press the bell icon on YouTube and don't miss another update.
The Modi government has carried out a massive review of VIP protectees, and in that process, it has removed the security cover for certain politicians and downgraded the protection category for others. Now, in government matters today, what we are trying to do is demystify this entire concept of providing security cover to VIPs and VVIPs and understand what the various categories are, what is the criteria for giving the cover, and what is the criteria for removing or reviewing such protection. In conversation with me today in the studio is Ananya Bharadwaj, who monitors the Home Ministry for us, which is in fact the ministry, nodal ministry responsible for providing and deciding on security cover for VIPs. Ananya, as I mentioned in my intro, we'll try and decode this entire concept, but just very quickly to tell our viewers, which have been the main politicians whose security cover has been removed or downgraded?
So, Ruhi, it's a long list. I think over 100 ministers, MPs. To name a few, Lalu Prasad Yadav, he's in jail right now. His security cover has been removed. Akhilesh Yadav, very important. His Z Plus security cover has been removed. The black cats essentially has been taken away from him. Then there is Rajiv Rudi, the MP, Lok Sabha MP.
Right.
Then Suresh Rana, Sangeet Singh Som, Dinesh Sharma, Chirag Paswan, even people from the BJP, RSS, Indresh Kumar, Acharya Pramod Krishan, who is the Akhil Bharatiya Sangh Samiti president. So it's a long list of people. Their security has either been downgraded from Z to Y or have been taken away. In many cases, we have seen that the CRPF security cover has been taken away. In some cases, the CISF security cover has been taken away. And in most cases, the names have been completely removed from the central list
of VIP protectees. Now, Ananya, this is a huge exercise, which is, I think, the first of its kind by the Modi 2.0 government. Just to understand, what is the criteria for providing security cover? How do you decide who gets it, and what is the category that each person gets?
Okay, so it's like a three-way process, Ruhi. So starting from the person who's given security is decided by the virtue of the position that person holds. So if it's, say, like a minister or a cabinet minister or an MP, like the PM, it depends on what position and what power you hold in the government. Like the PM has the SPG security.
Right.
And most cabinet ministers have the Z Plus security. But there are instances in which, like, I would like to talk about Home Minister Chidambaram, who had refused in Z Plus
Home
security.
Minister, right.
Former Home
right.
Minister had refused the Z Plus security, so it was a Z security for him. So this is by the virtue of the position that person holds in the government.
Right.
So I don't have to ask for that, or there need not be a threat perception, but that you get anyway because
sure.
you are in that position.
Sure.
Then secondly, an individual can ask for such a security if they say, if they feel that there is a threat perception, if
right.
their life is in danger.
Right.
So the process for that being that you have to first file an application, then the Home Ministry goes through it, there is a meeting, the threat perception is analyzed, and
right.
if they feel that this person really needs this security, then according to the threat perception, the category is decided.
Sure.
And the third being that, which is very interesting, it is completely based on intelligence inputs. They have certain inputs, or they've intercepted some calls in which they have found that an individual is under threat,
right.
That individual may or may not be aware of that. So even then a meeting is held, then a threat perception is analyzed and it's calculated, and then that person is given security. So that person may or may not ask for it,
right.
may or may not be aware of it, but then that security cover is given to that.
Now, as you mentioned, the post one holds, and then the threat perception, these are two very important reasons why a security cover is given, and how that's how it's determined. But what happens in case of when it's removed or it's downgraded? What is the criteria then? I understand if you no longer hold that position, then you will not get the same security cover. But in other cases, what happens? For instance, in this case, how was it determined?
So the process, as I explained, being that the committee will sit and then they'll analyze the threat perception again. So in this case, like, say, we talk about Lalu Prasad Yadav, he's in jail. So the argument being that he doesn't need security cover
while being in jail
because
right.
he's anyway in jail. So which is why it was taken away from him. Same in the case of Akhilesh Yadav. I won't say that the entire security cover was taken away. The black cats, which is the Z Plus, was taken away. Likewise, I mean, they have not given out specific reasons of why the security guard was taken from specific people. I mean, I don't think they prepare such a report, but the downgrade is done in one report, which is a comprehensive one, is prepared. That these are the security cover, these are the people who have been shortlisted for Z+, these are the people who have been shortlisted for Y, and a comprehensive list is then released.
And how often is this review done?
This review is done, if we talk about routine, it's about twice a year. So they sit down twice a year, and if there are some fresh applications, and if there are too many of applications, then the committee might just meet in between. But twice a year it's reviewed.
Now going forward, what does it mean for those who've lost their central security cover, or those who felt that it's been downgraded without any reason?
So Ruhi, it's not something that cannot be reviewed. So as I said, it's reviewed twice a year. So it can also be reviewed if a person feels that he has been wronged and he still needs security. There's a high threat perception. That person can again put in an application and the committee will sit again and the analysis would be done again. So as I said, it's a continuous process. If the government feels that the threat perception is more, then it can be upgraded or downgraded accordingly.
Right.
So it's not that if the cover has been taken away, it cannot be taken again, but that only depends on what grounds the person gives to take that security cover.
Right. Now, Ananya, there's been this entire debate around how a lot of taxpayers' money goes into providing this security cover, and perhaps that's also a reason why a periodic review is necessary. But is that the sense in the government as well, that a lot of these security covers, the VIP protectees, may be unnecessary beyond a certain point of time?
Ruhi, it's not just this government. I would like to mention that it happens in every government.
Right.
when they come to power, there is a security review that's
sure.
done. I remember when in the last government as well, Home Minister Rajnath Singh had done this review, and lot of security cover was taken away from lot of people. Lot of people had, the security cover was downgraded for a lot of them. So it's a continuous process. Yes, of course, when we talk to the Home Ministry officials, they say that Home Minister Amit Shah especially had mentioned in one of his meetings that this VIP culture needs to end. So I think it's one of those initiative.
That.
Yeah, is one of those. So which is why this committee was called in and the assessment was done. And it's while the parliament is on, it was taken.
Now it's very interesting that you mentioned that Home Minister Amit Shah said the VIP culture should end, and this is probably a part of that exercise. Do you think the extent of this exercise and the number of names that were reviewed is larger than normal?
Yes, absolutely. Last time I remember, in the last government, there were about 50 to 52 people who were reviewed, but this time, as I said, the list is more than 100.
Right.
And we are hearing that there is going to be soon another review in which more we could expect more names.
Right. So, Home Minister Amit Shah leaving his footprint in ways more than one, and this time it's about getting rid of the VIP culture, as he said. And one of the processes he's following in that is trimming the security cover that is given out to VIP protectees. That was Ananya Bharadwaj decoding this entire exercise for us. Thank you so much for watching Government Matters.